Hello, everybody, and welcome back to a brand new episode of Danny and Courtney Talk About. I'm Danny, and with me, as always, is.
Courtney, also known as Animation Enthusiast.
Yes, and as always, it's so wonderful to have you joining me today. Now, this episode, if my memory serves me correctly, was actually requested to me some time ago by a user named Mr. Homestar Jughead. He also wanted us to review the movie Jersey Boys, but since we haven't seen that, we're gonna put that one on hold for a while. But instead, we're going to be talking about another Marvel comic movie that came out this year, and that movie is.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
That's right. Now, Courtney, would you mind sharing with everyone what it's about?
Certainly. Guardians of the Galaxy tells the story of a Ravager named Peter Quill, or Star-Lord, who was searching for a mysterious artifact that's incredibly valuable to both the space pirates he works for and the evil Ronan the Accuser. Along the way, he encounters an alien assassin named Gamora, who is also looking for the artifact to sell to her employer, an alien warrior named Drax, who wants vengeance against Ronan the Accuser, and two bounty hunters named Rocket Raccoon and Groot. After all five of them escape a space prison, they decide to work together to dispose of the artifact. And later on, they work to try and save the galaxy from Ronan the Accuser and his evil plans, thus becoming the official Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yep, that's the film in a nutshell. By the way, have you noticed I say that a lot in every review?
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, enough self-awareness. Now, for those who don't know, this is based off of a more obscure Marvel comic series, basically about five misfits who live in the galaxy far away, and they fight bad guys. And now here's a fun little story about when I first heard about this movie. My brother told me about it. Like, I think at the time there, I think San Diego Comic-Con was going on, and they were announcing big projects. And when my brother told me about this movie, and he well, basically he described them by the five main characters. When he described it, I was like, well, this would be a very good animated movie. Is it going to be animated? And he said, no, it's going to be live action. And when I heard that, I was like, oh, I don't know. That's I don't think that's going to be very good. Because, I mean, in animation, talking raccoon and a tree person and some aliens, that could work. But,
It
like,
could work.
yeah, it could, but live action, I was a little skeptical because, like, I don't know. You have to have a real big suspension of disbelief with that stuff. And sometimes, even when they do that, it doesn't always work out. So I was a little skeptical of it. But eventually, when it did come out, back in the summer, and I heard very good things about it, I went and checked it out. Twice, actually, once with my best friend and once with my parents. But before I share what I think, what did you think of this movie, Courtney?
I actually got interested because it has a little tie-in to the Avengers movie, so I decided to see it earlier in the week in celebration of my birthday, and I actually really enjoyed it. I liked the plot, I liked the characters, I loved the special effects. I just loved everything about this film.
Yeah, I love same that's the same opinion here with me. I love this movie. Now I'll admit when you get down to it, I was kind of right. It is pretty stupid. But at the same time, they kind of know it and they're having a lot of fun with it. And I think that's what I admire most is that even though the whole like idea is silly, they're having lots of fun. There's a lot of great action. All the characters are memorable. There's a lot of memorable lines. The most memorable, of course, being I am Groot. And yeah, it really exceeded my expectations. I'm glad I saw it. I think the best way I can describe it is basically imagine how a little boy would probably do his own, like, space superhero adventure with all sorts of characters from his imagination. Is that a good way of describing it?
I mean, I would think it makes sense because you have, this guy who was abducted, you have the raccoon, you have the mutant tree, you have the destroyer guy,
And
and
you
you have
got the
the
sexy
Drax,
green chick.
and the sexy green chick, so.
Yeah. Of course, all little boys love the sexy aliens. But anyway, actually, I guess we can talk about all of them right now. The five main characters. Let's start with Peter Quill, or Star-Lord, as he prefers. What do you think about Peter in this movie?
Well, first of all, like in the beginning, I feel really sorry for him because, first of all, and this is kind of spoiler, his mom dies due to cancer, and then shortly after that, he's abducted. And keep in mind, this was like in like the late 80s when he got abducted, so he only knows stuff from like the 80s, and then of course a few things before then from like his mom.
Courtney, that's not really a spoiler. That happens in like the first 5 minutes of the movie.
Oh, well, I knew that.
But yeah, that's right. I love that about him. Like, I love that, he thinks he's a really cool guy, and he's very good at what he does, and he's got a nice ship. And I love that he has like a whole playlist of songs from the 70s and the 80s that we hear throughout the movie. But at the same time, there's sort of like this childlikeness of him. Like, he thinks he's cool, but he's not really. And he's kind of got a little bit of an ego with the whole Star-Lord thing. Now on to the next main character, Gamora. Or, as I said, the sexy alien chick with green skin. What'd
Oh,
you
you
think of
said it.
Gamora?
I kind of liked her as a character because originally, she was kind of like this assassin kind of like character, but then like as the movie goes on, she's kind of tears from it, and she and thing and stuff.
Yeah, I liked her too. I liked that she had sort of a no-nonsense personality, and she took her job seriously. And they establish early on that she's basically genetically improved to be like the perfect like killing machine. And I think she works off all the other characters pretty well, and she's not bad looking either. Now on to Drax. What'd you think of Drax?
Okay, again, another character I felt really sorry for because his family dies and he's out to get revenge, and it's you think he'd be one of those characters where you wouldn't really like, considering like in the beginning he was kind of this vicious character that wanted Gamora's life and everything.
Yeah. Actually, if I could be perfectly honest, Drax is my favorite character in the whole movie. 'Cause yeah, like you
Really?
said, yeah. Like one reason being, like you said, he has like a really good backstory and he has a very clear motivation. And another thing I really like about him is that he takes everything like seriously and literally. Like anytime someone says like an expression or a metaphor, he'll get really confused. Like when we first meet him, and like when Peter's trying to convince him to join them, he's like, "You join us, we find the destroyer. You can," and then he puts his finger on his throat, and he's like, "Why would I want to put my finger on his throat?"
And we're seeing Oscar Marion. Tentacles and needles for teeth. I think I'm seriously interested in that. You don't care. But here's the point. She betrayed Ronan. He's coming back for her. And when he does, that's when you...
Why would I put my finger on his throat?
What? Oh, no, it's a symbol. This is a symbol for you slicing his throat.
I would not slice his throat. I would cut his head clean off.
It's a general expression for you killing somebody. You've heard of this. You've seen this, right? You know what that is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Everyone knows.
No.
That was hilarious.
I know. It was funny.
And then, of course, later on, when Rocket Raccoon explains that metaphors go right over his head, he's like, "Nothing goes over my head. My reflexes are too fast."
Oh my god.
Another thing I admire about him is, and I read this off of an interesting Tumblr post of that gift set. Basically, some guy took his autistic little brother to see this movie, and when he saw that character, he's like, "That's me! That's me!" Because a lot of people with autism can't really, like, take metaphors very well, and to see that right. represented, that's very, it's wonderful of them to include that. Because like mm-hmm. we said, you know, representation matters in film. And
yeah.
the more mm-hmm. you can represent of different people, the better.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I really like Drex. Now onto the two most popular characters from this movie. And the two characters I was kind of skeptical about, because they're the most, when you think about it, ridiculous. Let's start with Rocket. What do you think about Rocket Raccoon?
So, Rocket, right next to Groot, is actually one of my favorite characters in the film. And I just love how, like, he's easily aggressive, and he's this weapon specialist. But at the same time, you do feel sorry for him because he was like this experiment.
Yeah. Now, I want to ask you something. Did you recognize that was Bradley Cooper doing his voice?
Well, actually, not while watching it, but then actually when I saw this with my aunt, she's like, "Hey, that was Bradley Cooper." And I'm like, "Really? I did not know that."
Yeah, I'll be honest.
The
when
voice, I mean...
Yeah, when I first saw, like, heard, like, Rocket Raccoon talking, I was like, that does not sound like Bradley Cooper. It sounds more like Jason Alexander. So, I gotta give Bradley Cooper credit for doing a great job voicing Rocket. And, of course, you know, I liked him a lot, too. He's kind of this smart-alecky kind of character who obviously has a lot of, like, flaws. Like, he's very greedy, and he's kind of... gets very angry easily. But at the same time, you can't help but admire him for his determination and his, like, snarkiness.
Yeah, that's true. Mm-hmm.
And now on to the fan favorite. What did you think about Groot?
Groot was adorable. Like, he doesn't really say much other than "I am Groot," but I don't know, his actions were just adorable. And then, like, in combat, he was pretty cool because one of the scenes that I liked was when he released the spores to provide light.
Yeah, I liked that too. I mean, well, that's what you'd probably expect a tree person to do. Yeah, I like Groot too. He certainly stole the show. And here's a fun story. When I took my parents to see this movie, my dad first thought that Vin Diesel was playing Drax. He was so surprised to find out that Vin Diesel was actually playing Groot.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, he did a very good job playing Groot.
I thought so too.
Yes. I guess now we can talk about the other characters, because there are indeed other characters in this movie. Are there any others that stuck out to you?
I thought Ronan was a pretty interesting antagonist in the film.
Yeah, I liked him too. I liked how at first they kind of set it up that maybe he's just a minion, but then they change it so that they make him the main bad guy. I hope that wasn't a spoiler. I also like the the cop that, you know, recognizes Peter and kind of, like, he was pretty fun, too.
Mm-hmm.
There's a really funny scene later towards the climax where he's trying to convince the other, like, people on the home planet to help the Guardians, and he's relaying the message, and there's some rather inappropriate things said in it. But I'm not going to give away.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. So, yeah, I thought they were all good. Now, there is one character who I thought was I was like, it was wonderful seeing. But, of course, that requires you to sit until through the entire credits to the very end. I'm not going to say anything. All I will say is, if you see this movie, be absolutely sure to sit through the sit till the end, because there's a very special character who appears.
Well, technically, two, I guess. I'm not saying anything, but yes, I've known, like, throughout watching any Marvel movie to sit through those credits, because you will have a little treat at the end.
Yes, we're not going to say who shows up, but you guys are going to love it.
Yeah, you may be surprised, actually, because actually when I watched the end, I was like, oh, I didn't know they included that character in, those characters. So
now that we got all the characters out of the way, did you have a favorite moment in this film? Or if, like, a favorite scene or favorite line of dialogue? Anything?
I liked the scene where they were breaking out of jail, which was kind of like in the beginning of the movie. And then at one point, Gamora says, I'm going to die among idiots.
Yeah, that was my favorite part, too. Like, when they break out of prison, like, together, and you see all of them working together. And, of course, there's one really funny exchange where, like, Rocket says in order to, like, escape, they need this one guy's leg, and Peter actually goes and gets the leg, and when he brings it, he's like, oh, no, I was joking, you know? Why didn't you just... I thought it would be funny.
Oh, my God. And then he tries it again with this eye and whatever, and then... Yeah, that was just funny.
Yeah, I remember that. He's like, yeah, we need that, and we need that guy's eye. No, we don't need that guy's eye. No, yes, yeah, we do. Yeah, it was wonderful. Yeah, and of course there were some other good scenes too. Like, I liked how each of the main characters was introduced early on in the film. And of course, like I said earlier, I loved that scene at the very end of the credits, but I'm not going to reveal who or what happens.
So, I would say this, the quote-unquote scene before that scene, but that may be spoilers as well.
Maybe. I know something that just came to mind. What did you think about this movie's soundtrack? Which, as I said...
I loved the soundtrack. I just thought, like, it was just, like... It was just awesome to listen to, like, these old songs, and you're like, oh, yeah, I remember that song.
Yeah. Yeah, I like the soundtrack, too. My parents agreed with me, except for the Pina Colada song. They don't like that song, but other than that, it's I think it's a pretty good soundtrack, especially if you love music from the 70s and the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
It's mainly the 70s, I think. But,
I think so, too.
Mm. Yeah.
Although, there was that one reference to the 80s movie called Footloose.
Oh, yeah, I love that scene. Yeah, that was funny, where he basically described the movie Footloose as kind of like an old legend from his planet.
Yeah.
And, of course, there was a line, like, and apparently Gamora is very similar to Drax, where... He says, like, a metaphor, where Peter says a metaphor, and she takes it literally. Like, I think he says, he travels to a town where everyone has sticks up their butts. He's like, that's just cruel. Nobody should have sticks up their butts. Oh, no, it's an expression. That was funny. Let's see, is there anything else interesting about this movie we can mention?
Oh, what about The Collector? Now, for those who don't know, The Collector was actually in the movie Thor 2, and so he makes an appearance in this movie.
Yes, that's right, and yeah, he was a pretty interesting character. And it was an interesting way to tie that movie into the other Marvel movies. Mm-hmm. Now, it would be amazing if the Guardians showed up in a future Avengers movie. But I don't know if that's going to happen because, A, that would require a lot of visual effects. And this movie already had a lot. And B, that would, like, it would be very expensive overall. But if they did manage to do it, that would be amazing. I would love to see how, like, characters like Iron Man and Captain America and Hulk and Thor, I'd love to see how they would interact with, like, Star-Lord and Gamora and Drax and Rocket. I would imagine Iron Man would get along very well with Rocket.
Oh, definitely. And I can imagine Peter getting some sort of culture shock, kind of like a Captain America in a way.
Yeah, that I can see where you're coming from on that. So yeah, I know it's probably not going to happen, but if it does, Marvel, you better do a great job on that. You will not disappoint any of us.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, until that happens, I guess we can get excited for whenever the next movie's coming. Because this is because at the very end of the movie, without spoiling what happens, they do have a little title card that says "The Guardians will return."
Yeah, so there, for all we know, there could be a sequel coming out in a few years. We'll just have to wait and see. Unless they're pulling our legs for some reason. But
yeah, because they think it's funny.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't know. No, they're pretty good at, like, following up. And I think this movie made quite a lot of money at the box office. I don't think they're going to turn down a sequel.
Yeah, and if I can recall, and I think it made about as much as The Avengers and Iron Man 3, or maybe a little over, or somewhere around there, I think.
Yes, and if I recall, both of those movies made quite a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I guess we can give our overall thoughts now. Will you go first?
Overall, I give this a huge thumbs up. I enjoyed the story, as I said. I liked the characters and how they developed throughout the movie. I loved the soundtrack and basically the different references made in the movie, such as, like, with the soundtrack.
Yes, and I give this movie a very big thumbs up as well. I was very pleasantly surprised. I'm glad they managed to take such a silly idea and make it work. And I'm glad they had fun with it. I loved all the characters, and I think you guys will love it. Even if you're not really into comic book movies, I think, or space movies, I think you'll still get a kick out of it because it has a lot of fun with itself. Anyway, that was our discussion. This is Danny saying, "I am Groot." No, I'm just kidding. This is Danny here saying, "I am awesome," and so are all of you. And Courtney is especially awesome because that's just the way of the galaxy.
And you're awesome too, Danny. And this is Courtney, also a Groot. Not really. Signing out.
Anyway, take care, folks.